And of course it's raining.
It's raining. The weather's supposed to be crap again today, but at least there's a coffee maker.
Hot pockets, coffee, and a sticky bun. All while listening to the gentle sound of rain hit the roof and the occasional sound of an Amber Alert coming off of a phone that's hidden somewhere in this room that I can't find.
So apparently that gas pipeline attack that's been in the news has been causing some consternation in this area. I was talking to some people yesterday who had gotten one of those resupplies where the guy meets you on the side of the trail. He couldn't come to them because he didn't have any gas. And a bunch of people who plan to jump up to Damascus for trail days are now kind of finding that it's either going to be really expensive or that their rides, again, can't get gas. Always something.
So it looks like everybody else who's staying here is going to be slack packing out of here. So it's going to just be me on the Sam's Camp shuttle.
My daughter works over in Johnson City.
Okay, after a really pleasant night, a really pleasant morning, it is now slightly less than pleasant. I'm also really wishing that Taters had gotten me that new rain skirt, because mine isn't actually waterproof.
Oh, on the plus side, at least it's really bloody cold in addition to being wet and windy.
The rain's been one thing. It's been light to moderate, depending on the time. It's rather chilly though, and this rain skirt really is not worth a damn. It wets out pretty easy, so it's not keeping my thighs warm. I have another that's coming from ULA I really can't wait to get.
Pretty out here. Could do with maybe a little bit of sunlight, but I know, overly picky. Or maybe more pizza. So this has been kind of a long, really, really cold day for a while there. Somebody left a comment on one of my videos saying, enjoy the cool, damp weather while you got it, because summer's going to hit. And you know, at least right now, I would be really okay with summer. Anything brings its own challenges out here, but I wouldn't mind being warm for a while, you know. Okay, finally out of the fog again. Which I'm grateful for, because that fog is bloody cold today. Okay, so it's only 6 o'clock, and normally I'd be pushing to do a couple of more miles, but I'm just beat between the cold and having to fight slipping in all that mud just for hours this morning. I'm beat, so home sweet home for the night. People really complain too much about campsites. This was listed by at least one or two gut hooks comments as being uneven and horrible. I mean, it's just about perfect, especially in a rainy area.
The most joyous part of the morning is waking up and getting to drink coffee. The most hideous part of the morning is waking up and having to leave my worn sleeping bag to pee. Blah.
Okay, so today is a quasi-town day. I will be down in Irwin in a couple of miles. Uncle Johnny's is apparently the hostel that's right along the way. And they say they have a small outfitter, so it depends. If I can find 3 days worth of food that I think is decent there, I'll just buy there. If it's super expensive, I may try and get a ride into town and resupply at Walmart. Because some of these on-trail resupplies do get a little on the pricey side. Well, look at that. Sunshine. Still cold as all hell this morning, but this is an improvement.
And here comes the stench of civilization once again. With maybe coffee.
Okay, a couple of hours, one charged phone, 3 hot pockets, and a soda later. Time to get going again. Okay, that stop took only about 2 hours. Buying food was relatively quick. I was mostly just waiting for my phone to recharge and taking care of a couple other things and eating hot pockets. So it looks like the trail might be clearing out for a couple of days with trail danger. Sorry. See what happens when I try and read warning signs while I'm talking? Seems like a whole heck of a lot of people are jumping up to Damascus for trail days. There really is a certain sense of freedom when I've got 3 or 4 days of food on my back. Since I know I can just hike and, you know, stop wherever I want, do whatever I want. I don't have to worry about time in town, out of town, package pickups, anything like that. Sunshine and a view-ish.
Okay, this is the shelter. Just gonna grab some water and then it's down the trail. Try and find a little bit less occupied area. Have I mentioned how just damn satisfying the pipe springs are? Okay, well, 21 and a half miles, which isn't too bad considering this was a resupply day. It's now about 8:15, so home sweet home for the night. This will work. So my resupply this time is pretty much a bunch of bars and these, because that's what they had at Johnny's. Another chilly night. I'm really looking forward to, you know, warming up eventually. There are some really, really enthusiastic woodpeckers hanging around here. See, woodpeckers. Weather for the next couple of days is reportedly going to be cold and partly cloudy. May get some sun off and on. It came out weekly a while back, but rain chance is minimal at least. It did rain just a bit right after I got in the tent last night, but then quit. I did get an umbrella warning from my phone this morning, or this afternoon at 4 p.m. So we'll see. Part of the problem with those pinpoint forecasts, though, is, you know, by 4 I'll be 10, 15 miles up the trail. So I might miss whatever clouds are going on. No real goal for today. Just looks like more of the same. Maybe a little less climbing than yesterday. A couple of balds along the way, which may have a view. And in a couple of days, I'll get to, I think Hampton is where I was looking at resupplying. There's a Dollar General there. So I've still been having those painful wart issues. Tater sent me some pads, which are supposed to dissolve on, but you have to wear them pretty long. The problem is, anytime you're hiking, it's hard to keep anything on your foot. Like, if I have some of this climber's tape on the bottom of my foot, it'll just embed into the sock by the end of the day. I'm trying it, though, because the pain's getting kind of distracting here. I am just dragging today. Maybe I do need to think about taking a zero when I can. Hit Hughes Gap, and there was another trail angel gathering, so we had some trail magic. Neat guys and a lady, but it's cold. And now not only is it really cold, but it's raining again. Of course, at least I got some uphill to warm up on. Bit of a view, and now it's warmed up since that storm blew through. And of course, still going up. Well, that's a bit random. Okay. Yeah, that's not too bad. Unfortunately, I seem to be hitting weekend crowds out here. Haven't had any luck finding a campsite in the last hour or so. Yeah, still trying to find a campsite. 8:50 and still no luck. Actually climbed up a hill figuring, well, maybe there'd be a flat area up there, and found somebody already camped up there. So I must just be in a busy area. I am really ready to stop. Okay, so 9 o'clock and I finally found something open. Frickin' weekends, huh? So at least for today, the rumor is sunny and no rain, but we shall see. Bitterly cold last night, so I'm currently hiding in my sleeping bag, slurping down my coffee. It's about 40 degrees now, per the weather forecast. And like I said, last night it got really cold up here. And I had a hell of a time finding a campsite. I didn't actually get my tent set up till about 9 o'clock, because it's a Friday, and Roan Highlands, I think, is the name of the area. It's like James Bald and the surrounding area. Really beautiful. Nice views around sunset, but there were weekenders everywhere. You can tell from their gear that they're not going very far in. I was very happy to find this site because I didn't know how far I was going to have to go. I've also been feeling pretty run down the last couple of days. Usually when that happens, I start looking to take a zero day because, you know, day after day pushing, that just kind of runs you down. A zero is a good way to replenish that. However, the only two options for that are going to be Hampton in 2 days and then Damascus, which is a couple of days after that. Unfortunately, I could have been taking a break in Damascus right now at trail days, but that didn't really work out. I looked into it, but the shuttles that were available were prohibitively expensive and it just didn't feel right, you know, spending money screwing around versus being able to continue the trail and all that. So, well. Which is really a shame because I was looking forward to meeting a few people that I know were up ahead that I probably won't catch up with. Also, if it is ever super cold and you do not want to get out of your sleeping bag, incidentally, you can use mountain houses as like a pee bottle. So at least for today, the rumor is sunny and no rain, but we shall see.
Okay, so it looks like I am 4 days from Damascus and two from Hampton. So my plan's going to be go to Hampton. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to run in. It's like a mile off trail from what I can see and get another 2 days of food because I'm going to be on fumes by the time I get there. But Dollar General, so maybe hiker wine, etc., etc. And once I get to Damascus, I'll probably try and take a zero there. It's the end of another section and, you know, I've been going for a while. So if you wonder why I grumble about dizzy trails, have you ever been driving like a long distance on a two-lane highway and you end up passing some trucks, which, you know, takes a little bit of effort, and then you need to pee, but you know, if you pull over to pee, then you're going to have to like repass all those trucks again. Same thing with hiking. So Taters has a flight into Roanoke on the 6th, and then she will be with me for about 10 weeks. Now we still have to figure out how to get her shuttled from Roanoke to wherever I'm going to be. I'll probably try and find some place to have a zero, say, on the 5th. That way I'm fairly fresh when she joins me, rather than, you know, I'm worn down to a nub while she's all enthusiastic and ready to go. Last year on the PCT, she joined me around Tehachapi, which sadly was right around when I was having my big Achilles issue. So after only a couple of days of pretty pathetic mileage, we ended up having to take some days off in Tehachapi, which is not exactly the garden spot of Mojave. That's not a bad view. And there's that old barn that's a collapsed shelter. Those almost look like some real mountains over there. Wow, not bad at all. The AT should really do more of this. Well, damn, turns out if I hadn't been out of touch last night, I may have ended up at trail days. Bopit actually has a rental car and was making the offer, but I didn't find out till this morning. Ah, well. Well, bummer to miss trail days, but at least I got to do this section in good weather. Sadly, I just turned down another beer. Ay, that's so painful to do. But I mean, it's morning. I have like 12 more miles to go today. Leaving North Carolina again. Wonder if this is the last time. Been on the border between Tennessee and North Carolina since what, the Smokies? This has just turned into a disgustingly pleasant afternoon. I'm sure that means there's a tornado or a blizzard coming tomorrow. I've really been enjoying this section. Hey, Trailside Cemetery. That gets me all nostalgic for, you know, the first 2,000 miles or so. So I was just sitting there drinking my lemonade and feeling a bit run down after 20-some miles. And somebody popped around the corner and recognized me.
I'm Richard. And I'm Reggie. And we've been watching all your videos, man. Awesome, dude.
They inspire us, dude.
Yes, absolutely.
Nothing like getting the minor celebrity treatment to kind of pick up my step a bit. A couple more miles. Okay, so that's Hump Mountain over there that I came off this morning. Okay, getting towards 8 o'clock, so I'm gonna fill up at the next water source and then start eyeing places to stop. The resupply situation around Hampton doesn't seem as straightforward as I thought. It's either 2.2 miles to get to a Dollar General, or it looks like I can get to a hostel that's a mile off a road and I might be able to get a ride. Hostel resupplies aren't great, but all I need is another 2.5 days or so to get to Damascus, so that is a little bit tempting. Okay, I passed up a streamside spot because the ground had a bunch of roots and stuff in it, and got me another mile, so I got a good 24-mile day in. Home sweet home for the night, and then resupply tomorrow, so more food, which I really need.